this summer, take a magical trip to a world unlike any other. An enchanting place where adventure is only a whistle away. Destination Films presents Alec Baldwin, Peter Fonda, Mara Wilson, and Thomas.
Little engines can do big things.
Things are gonna change around here, Puffball.
Thomas and the Magic Railroad. Rolling into theatres everywhere, July 2000.
Welcome to a magical new world where a very special friend invites you to climb aboard on his biggest adventure ever. See him for the first time on the big screen. It's Thomas the Tank Engine.
Who else were you expecting?
Join Thomas in Thomas and the Magic Railroad. Meet Mr. Conductor.
All aboard!
Important day, Mr. C.
It is a very important day.
Out of the way!
Now someone's causing all kinds of trouble.
Hello. Junior, you've got to come here right away.
The sparkle has left.
I've run out of gold dust, and because of that, I'm losing my energy as well.
Just hold on, cuz.
And it will take a hero with nerves of steel.
Don't worry, I'm on my way.
To bring the magic back.
I'll get you, you blue puffball!
This is just like the fun fair.
I don't think you meant to do that.
No.
Losing your sparkle, eh? What perfect timing.
Alec Baldwin.
I've got to find more gold dust.
Peter Fonda.
This is your shining time, too.
And Mara Wilson.
You're a really useful engine, Thomas.
Star of Matilda.
Now that's what I call a perfect landing.
In Thomas and the Magic Railroad.
I'll save a seat for you.
July 26th, there's only one party rolling down the track.
Junior, look!
It's Thomas!
Thomas and the Magic Railroad.
Woohoo! You're a really useful engine, Thomas.
Watch out, it's dangerous!
Featuring the single Locomotion by the Atomic Kitten.
Whoa!
Thomas and the Magic Railroad, rated G, starts Wednesday, July 26th.
FamilyWonder.com says Thomas will win the hearts of parents and kids alike.
This is just like the fun fair.
Kids will cheer for Thomas.
Well done.
Thomas and the Magic Railroad.
I'll save a seat for you.
Rated G starts Wednesday, July 26th.
This summer's hit movie is coming to video and DVD Tuesday. Thomas and the Magic Railroad.
Well done, Thomas.
It's a magical movie.
Whoa.
Where Thomas and his friends come to life.
He's beautiful.
With fun for the whole family. Thomas and the Magic Railroad.
Little engines can do big things.
Whoa. Available Tuesday on VHS and DVD. Rated G.
On Wednesday, July 26th.
Look,
it's Thomas.
What?
Get ready for the ultimate family adventure.
Whoa! I've got to find more gold dust.
And I'm going to help you.
Thomas and the Magic Railroad. Rated G. Wednesday, July 26th.
All aboard!
From Destination Films comes the ultimate movie for you and your family.
Whoa! You can run, but you can't hide.
I'm going to help you.
Thomas.
On Wednesday, July 26th.
You're a really useful engine, Thomas.
Thomas hits the big screen.
Well done!
This is just like the fun fair!
Thomas and the Magic Railroad, rated G, starts Wednesday, July 26th.
What's the big rush?
You can run, but you can't hide!
Thomas the Tank Engine is going to the movies.
It is a very important day.
You and your family are invited to join Mr. Conductor.
I've got to
find more gold dust.
Lily and Thomas.
This is just like the fun fair.
On the biggest adventure a little engine ever had.
I'll save a seat for you.
All aboard.
Thomas and the Magic Railroad. Rated G. Wednesday, July 26th.
Hey, Mr. C, why do you look so tired? Is it because I'm red? Diesel says red is a very tiring color, but Mr. C, red looks so nice against the snow. It's not me, is it?
You might have noticed there that although the train's eyes roll around in its head, the lips don't move. That's one of the strange decisions that went into Thomas and the Magic Railroad, a muddled and meandering movie based on the popular children's books from England and also the long-running PBS series about Thomas the Tank Engine. His lips don't move either, but I don't think it's a good idea. Alec Baldwin plays Mr. Conductor, who travels between the imaginary island of Sodor, which is made of miniatures and special effects, and the full-size town of Shining Time.
The journey from Shining Time keeps getting bumpier and bumpier.
Does it? A big bully Diesel is back, Mr. Conductor. You had better be careful.
The plot involves a scheme by mean-spirited Diesel trains to take over from the steam engine.
Oh, I see you forgot to bring the sugar. How careless of you. Say hello to Peachy.
Peter Fonda is also in the movie playing the caretaker for Lady, a locomotive that controls the precious local commodity of magic dust.
Watch out for the viaduct. It's dangerous.
Now I'll get you, Burnett Stone.
No, you won't, because the magic you refuse to believe in will get the better of you.
You don't see it so much there, but Peter Fonda goes through most of this movie in what looks like a very deep depression, maybe clinical. He's depressed because he has trouble bringing Lady the locomotive back to life. I just can't make her steam, he says. Maybe he's also depressed because Thomas and the Magic Railroad seem so unsure of itself. Both Fonda and Baldwin seem stranded here in a world that never really becomes charming or magical or certainly even convincing.
Well, you know, Peter Fonda and Alec Baldwin, I'm watching these guys and thinking, what, James Woods wasn't available? I mean, the casting on this is unbelievable. And yeah, Peter Fonda seems to be in some other movie, and Alec Baldwin's trying to, I'm going to do a kids movie now. And you mentioned about the trains and how they don't talk. Now, trains are already stuck on tracks, right? So now they're stuck immobile sort of on tracks. They can only go this way. And remember,
And that's about the level of the animation
on here. And with all the fun things you can do these days with modern special effects, to have these little choo-choo trains
The lips don't move on PBS, but maybe that's because they have a low budget. But the lips should move. I mean, either that or the eyes shouldn't move. You know, take your choice.
Well, and read my lips. This is a bad movie.
Oddly enough, Fonda's performance is not bad. It's in the wrong movie. It should be in something by Eugene O'Neill.
Exactly.
He's sitting there, well, I just can't, you know, I've been here inside this mountain for all
very,
my life.
Very perplexing and
terrible
movie.
And a lady won't steam, and I'm just so depressed. And you're saying, you know, liven up, you know, this is for kids.